Hi there, my name's Steve, and I'm going to give you a wee demo of some of the features of Microsoft Power Apps working with Office 365 and SharePoint Online. So for anybody that's new to Power Apps, basically it's a non-developer development tool designed for citizen developers to build reasonably sophisticated solutions for mobile and web and tied to your Office 365 account. So in this example, I've built a little job tracker system, which has on the left-hand side of it a bunch of clients, and on the right-hand side of it a bunch of jobs. So it also has a few extra features, such as the search box up here. So if I type in the first few letters of company, it filters the list for words containing or customers containing the words CEO or the letters CO together. On the right-hand side, it's got a list of jobs which are linked to the company. So if I select a particular company, you'll see on the right-hand side it filters the list based on the selected customer. It also has the ability to add a new job. So I click the button here to create a new job for a company. I specify my client, specify the priority of the job, give it a title, demo one, and enter a date relating to this item. A nice little calendar control here. And specify a few details into the job. This is a demo of the job. Okay, so I'm going to submit that item and it will create an item in the list. Now you'll see that was a set associated with FluTech. I click onto this item here, got my demo item here. I can click to view that item, and then if I want to edit the item further, I can click into here and go, actually, please do this job in the wallet. So my customer seems to have jumped off here for some reason. Let's just get that down here. Specify them. Okay, so now I've got the extra detail related to that job down here. Now, I can, let's jump in and have a look and see how this app is actually built. So inside the Power App Studio, we can look at the sort of major attributes of the application. The application itself is made up of three screens. It's got the main screen, an edit job screen, and the view job screen. And on the right-hand side, it has a bunch of attributes, including the data sources, so two SharePoint lists. These SharePoint lists themselves are made up of a jobs list, sorry, which has a lookup field for priority, sorry, a choice list for priority, and a lookup list for client. The clients themselves added in this client list here. So if this list here is added to or updated, that automatically becomes available in the drop-down list for clients within the application itself, and the job information that's in here. So if I just refresh this, we'll see that new job which I've added just as we're doing the demo there. It should pop into the bottom of our list. So you'll see that that's coming down the bottom down here, and we can see the demo job tracker with the text detail that I entered in, next it, and the customer, etc. So back inside the designer, we have a number of elements that make the screen up. The first feature we use is the gallery feature, which is inserted from under here. We can basically assign different types of galleries and styles. In this case, I've used a vertical gallery, and then I've customized it by removing the bits I don't want and adding the bits I do. So this particular gallery here is then linked to the client data source, and the second gallery has been added and linked to the job data source. These two galleries themselves are actually put together using a formula. So if we look at the this value here, this item is actually the scheduled item based on a link through to the client ID. So it's looking for the ID of this in this value here. If they have the same client ID in the selected column, the lookup column, then it will display the item. If they don't, then they don't display. So that's how the filtering is done there. The search box up here, you'll see, is basically a text box which allows me to input some text. And then on this list here, gallery here, I've got it filtered by using the search criteria, looking for matching the title value in the SharePoint list against the text entered into this box here. So that allows me to create a simple search function. I have a button on the screen here as well. So the button, if I click on that one and look at the formulas up here, on select, it opens a new form. the edit job form, which is my form created down here inside my my edit job screen. So it's going to open the edit job form, and it's going to navigate to the edit job screen. So when I click this button, it will jump me onto this screen here, and it will activate this form. You'll see this form here itself has actually got a number of controls on it too. These items here are the form fields from the jobs list. And then down the bottom of the form, I've got some buttons. I've got a submit button. This submit button is linked to a formula, which is the submit form formula. Submits the edit job form, which is this form here which we've created, and then navigates us back to the main screen. So once it's submitted the item, it takes me back to the main screen. Or I can click cancel, and the cancel button will actually just take me straight back to the main screen without saving the changes on this particular form. The final form which I have in here is my view job form, which is slightly different. So the major difference between the edit job and the view job form is that one form is a view form, so viewing the content without being able to edit, whereas the second form is the same, an exact copy of the form, which I've copied using the duplicate screen feature here, simply a copy of that form, but in the properties of the form itself, I've specified that this form here is an edit, is a view form rather than a, should I select the job form here. You'll see it's this one here has got a display mode of, sorry, I'm actually in the edit data form here. So this one's actually got a this is the display version of the form versus the edit version of the form, which is in this particular field here. So as you can see, the forms themselves are pretty logical to put together. This is kind of a pretty simple application, but quite quick and easy to build, something you can make yourself in around about an hour with tinkering around, and probably a little bit longer, a few enhancements, you could probably make it a bit better, and not much more time than that. So you know, hopefully this has been an interesting and enjoyable, insightful video, and I look forward to showing you the next one.